Let's bring in Hans von Spakovsky. He's a senior legal fellow at the Heritage Foundation and a former DOJ official. What are some of the best legal arguments that Republicans and the Trump administration has as this new, well, I guess it's a new process and that it was just voted on last week. This is the first day under the impeachment inquiry as officially voted on by the House.
Well, look, the most striking thing about the resolution that was approved last week was how it differed from both the Clinton and Nixon resolutions. Remember, in those, the chairman of the Judiciary Committee and the ranking minority member acted jointly to issue subpoenas, to decide what witnesses to talk to. The one that was just approved last week gives the chairman of the Intelligence Committee, Adam Schiff, unilateral authority to determine what documents to get and who to bring in to testify. And the ranking minority member can only act with the okay of the chairman. In other words, he has to say, chairman, may I? That's very, very different.
And so is there only a political remedy or is there a legal prescription that can be applied here by the Republicans?
No, it's only a political remedy because the rules that are set up for impeachment, the courts are not going to interfere with that. The House can do what it wants to, but it's very clear that the Democrats are violating the historical precedents that have been set in how prior impeachments have been handled.
All right, well, we'll see if they pay any price for that. Thank you, Hans von Spakovsky. We appreciate it.